Samsung, since the S20 all up until the S22, have had issues of a green line popping up during the update process. People have speculated that this is because the phone heats up during the update process, which in turn destroys the display and creates that green line. I am here to show you how to decrease the chances of this happening using another method I have not seen anyone talking about. What I mean is updating using Odin. Odin is the Samsung firmware flashing software, and we'll use that to update our firmware. This is especially important if you want to move to One UI 7, which is where people reported the issue the most, as the phone cooks up very intensely during that update process. If you use Odin, this update page screen, which is usually a black page with One UI and a blue bar, if you use Odin, this screen is bypassed and it boots up as if the phone came out of the box with One UI 7. It is worth noting that it is not One UI 7 that brings the lines, but rather it is the process of getting One UI 7 that causes it. I have a video which I'm going to show you how to go about it, and I will be using my Samsung tablet to showcase this, but remember the process is universal. Phone or tablet, it's all the same. Only difference is my tablet does not have the One UI 7, so you only need to make sure you're downloading One UI 7, also known as Android 15, and use that instead of the Android 14 file that I'm going to use. Watch the full video, there are very important things. And with that, thank you, see you at the end. Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to flash the stock firmware for your Samsung device. This works for tablet and phones. Now, before we begin, just a warning. Please make sure your device is charged to at least 70% and is at least 70% when you begin flashing, as this prevents the device from switching off, leaving you with an overpriced paperweight. Also, try and use the manufacturer cable or a decent cable, preferably the one that came with your device, and make sure it's not worn out so you do not disconnect mid-flash. Lastly, I'm not responsible for any damage to your device. This process is relatively safe, but in case of anything, I'm not responsible for any loss of data or damages. Now, we can begin. The first step is to back up our data. Flashing involves a fair amount of risk, like the loss of data, so it's best to back up everything first and ensure that your data is indeed safe somewhere else where you can restore it at any time in case anything goes wrong. The next step is to get our firmware files. Samsung devices have model names. An example is this tablet, which is the Samsung Galaxy Tab A8, which is under the model name SMX200. It is also crucial to determine your software region. If you're in the States, your device is probably a US device unless stated otherwise, and so on and so on. Let's talk about where you can get the firmware. You can get the firmware from a site called SamFW. So we're going to head to samfw.com. Now here, you're presented with a nice clean website, and this is going to be our hub for all things Samsung firmware. I do not recommend any other site as they have download limits and they're just not that good. Now, you can look around, but our main concern is the search bar, and if you can remember previously, I told you to memorize your device's model name, and here is why. When you search the tablet, let's say you search Tab A8, you get 5 results, possibly representing LTE versions of the tablet or whichever other metric they use to categorize these tablets. Maybe region 2, but who knows? Feel free to research. Now we have 5 results, but from the model's name that we mastered, we know that our tablet is the X200, so we are going to go with that. Remember, the other model names are for other devices, and if you proceed with the wrong one, well. So, when we head into our model, we are presented in a nice section where we can have a look at our device specs, and down here we have the fun part. This is the CSC section where we pick the region of our device, and CSC stands for country specific code. And some code hold different meanings, so it's best to double check what code you are looking to use to get your firmware. An example will be the United States CSC code of XAR,
which refers to United States unlocked firmware. This is a region or carrier neutral firmware meant for unlocked devices in the USA that are not tied to any specific carrier such as AT&T, T-Mobile, or even Verizon. This means there are firmware that are specific to carrier devices like the ones I'm going to show on screen. And so, if a device is related to a carrier, it's best to flash a firmware that is under accurate carrier. Do not flash anything that is outside the carrier. Like if you are for AT&T, do not flash a Comcast firmware. Now, I cannot go in depth for every country due to carriers being many and I'm just not that knowledgeable. So I implore you to do some research and confirm if your device is unlocked or locked and what CSC code you should flash. If in the off chance you do not know what CSC code you should use, I will put a website link where you can get help on what to do and how to find that info. So go check down in the link in the description. And for me, my device is US unlocked, so I'm going to take the US XAR. So let's click there and wow, things have gotten a little bit more complex, but don't worry, I'm going to touch on what is necessary to know. The device CSC section, we have broken it down and the version is the firmware version, which basically identifies the firmware that you're flashing or the firmware that is listed. Now, what is bit stroke SW rev? Luckily, they give us a page we can refer to. So let's head on there and let's learn together. So we have a blog entry from the SAMFW team and they tell us this is the bit stroke binary value. When flashing Samsung firmware or downloading Samsung firmware, there is a value called bit, binary, or U. Actually, this value is another calling of SWRev. Samsung allows you to flash the firmware that has SWRev equal or higher current or higher than the current SWRev of your phone. In SAMFW, this value is called bit. The value starts from 0 to 9 and then continues to A, B, C, D, E, F. And A is higher than 9 and B is higher than A. They then go ahead to give us a way to check the SWRev or the binary or the bit value, which is to get into settings, then about phone, and then in software information and look at the build number. And they tell us that the fifth number on the right, fifth number from the right is our bit value, aka our SWRev, which I believe is a software revision, I'm not sure. And they give us another way to check, which is in the download mode, which we will check out later when we get there. The most important section here, where we are told we cannot flash a lower SWRev, which is important to take note of as we can brick the device this way. The best rule is to always flash the latest firmware or one that is of equal SWRev version to avoid this problem being an issue at all, as you can only go up. Otherwise, you may get errors like this. Now, let's go back to the page, and since I'm using the latest firmware, I do not have to check for this, but seeing the bit binary was 5 and that is the latest and is equal to the tablet, it means we are good to use it. This also means we cannot flash anything below like this DXH1, which has a bit value of 4, which is lower than my 5 and may bring issues. So let me download this one. And as you can tell, the other tabs tell you the OS and the build date, which you can set from newest to oldest and vice versa. Just make sure you get the latest build. That's it. That's literally it. Okay, so I have downloaded the software and we're ready for the next step. To download Odin. This is a software developed by Samsung and is what you are going to use to flash the stock firmware. I'm just going to give you a short tour of the software and you will start by seeing that it's a zip file, and when you unzip you find the following with a file for the drivers, where when you click on it you are directed to a website where you can download the device drivers. Please begin here and check Windows optional updates for any Samsung related updates, as these tend to be drivers too. Once you install and reboot, come to the .exe Odin file and it will launch the software. You can read this warning and click OK, but I forgot to tell you that you need to remove your Google accounts. This is because under Google, we have something similar to iCloud lock called the factory reset protection. And logging out of every Google account on the phone is the only way to bypass this lock, as if you leave accounts, you'll be prompted to log in back with an account that was previously used on the device before flashing. Otherwise, you'll be locked out of your device. So please, to keep it simple, just log out of everything first. And if you cannot log out of everything, you are kind of doomed. Now, just make sure that's clear. Click OK, and we are finally in Odin. It can look intimidating, but it's a simple software, so let us break it down. This section here is the progress section, which tells us on the progress by use of a progress bar and by words. Below here, the ID:com is what lights up to tell us that our device is successfully connected and recognized. If you connect your device and it is not detected, then you'll need to install the drivers. And I previously told you, and you can just go back and check what I said. On our left, we have three tabs, one for logs, options, and PIT. Pretty straightforward as to what the first two do, but what is the PIT? Well, let's click it. Oh no, well, let's back away then. Now, this is where we're going to work, and this may look like a bunch of random letters, but each have a meaning, and here they are on your screen. And this is where we input our firmware files. And if you head back to the firmware file which you unzipped, you'll see files corresponding with the letters. And for example, when you click AP, for example, it opens the directory and you're supposed to pick the AP file from the firmware folder that you downloaded, which in this case is the largest file. So it may take a bit and it might look like it crashed. So give it some time till it's done. And you can see the firmware file name in this little window. Now for B, L and CP, you do the same. Now for me, I do not have the CP firmware file, so I will leave it blank. Do the same if you do not have it, but in most cases you do. Now for the CSC section, you can see there's a home CSC and there's a regular CSC. Flash the home CSC if you want to keep all of your data, and flash the regular CSC if you want a factory reset and you just want to wipe everything. For me, I do not care, so I'm going to go with the standard CSC and delete everything. And now we have filled up all the necessary sections and we will be ready to start. But first we need to head into options. Then we turn off auto reboot. There is no need to touch anything else here, so please leave it as it is. Now we are ready to flash and we need to boot the device into download mode, which is a mod specific to Samsung devices that allows us to flash the stock firmware or firmware in general, custom or official. For new devices, you need to plug in your USB on your laptop. Then while holding volume up and down button, plug it in. And for older devices, you can check your screen and adjust to watch whichever fits your device. Once held in, you'll be taken into this scan screen, which is a warning screen. And as you can read here, since we want to just continue into the download mode, we just press the volume up mode. We do not want to unlock our bootloader for now. And actually, not at all. We do not need to unlock the bootloader. So please avoid this. And now we are officially in download mode. And we can see the bit value right here. And you can see it's 4. Now, once we're in download mode, we can go back to Odin. And since we're already plugged in, we can see our device here. And let's go ahead and click start. And as you can see, it's beginning to flash. And we can see the progress in the log here as well as up here. So let's give it some time to finish flashing. Now we are all done with this nice green light and we can now move on to the next step, which is booting into the OS, which we can see on our screen, which we hold the volume down button and the power button. So let's do that. and I'm holding, and it's rebooting. And we are basically done. We have flashed the stock firmware successfully, and it's going to take some time, but that's it. If you did everything correctly, you should boot right into the system. But if you had an issue where your device is stuck or boot looping, just boot back into download mode and do this step all over again. All in all, you should be good. As you can see, we're in the setup screen now, and my device is ready to set up, and it's running the stock firmware, or may I say the latest stock firmware. I hope you helped, and if you had any issues, you can reach out through my Telegram or leave a comment below. I also have a guide where I can show you how to flash a custom ROM from every device along with support. And for the whole of December, I am putting it at 50% off if you use the code 50PA OFF. Get the full guide for only $10, and you can also donate to the channel separately on the Ko-fi page. If you want to watch a video on how to flash a custom ROM for your Samsung, just watch this video right here, where I go in depth into the topic, and it's free and simple to follow. Go check it out. See you.